Welcome children. Today I am going to take your history as well as civics class. Let me first take your history class. South India and the Cholas. Today's topic is Rajendravan Gangaikonda. Rajendravan succeeded his father Rajarajavan. He annexed the whole of Sri Lanka in about 1017 AD and organized the Pandya Kerala territories and the island of Sri Lanka in his own empire. Then marched towards the northern region of the Ganga Valley. He even captured Odisha and a portion of eastern Bengal. He took the title of Gangaikonda to celebrate this event and built a new capital called Gangaikonda Cholapuram, present name Gangakondapuram. In 2025 AD, he dispatched a naval expedition for the conquest of King Shailendra's territory of Java and Sumatra. An estimate of Rajendravan. Rajendravan constructed an artificial lake near his new capital. Its embankment were more than 25 km in length and was filled with water from the Koleran and Vellar rivers. He also constructed a temple at Gangaikonda Cholapuram, whose huge lingam was made of solid granite. Administration of the Cholas. The Chola administration provided a pattern for kingship followed by other rulers of South India. The Chola monarch, his administration and other officials, the whole system was based on the king. Festivals were held to celebrate the coronation ceremony. The power and glory of the monarch was marked by the huge resources of the kingdom, vast palace and splendor of the court. The king had a number of ministers representing a particular department to advise him on administrative affairs. Many of the officers were hereditary provinces and other territorial division. The kingdom was divided into provinces called mandalams, each under the charge of a viceroy. The provinces were further divided into division. The other units of administration were district, the group of villages and the village. Village administration, Gram Sabha. The exceptional efficiency of the village institution was the most remarkable feature of Chola administration. The assemblies enjoyed full powers in the management of local affairs. The village assembly administered justice within the village. They regulated water supply, gathered taxes and administered all charitable institutions. The smaller committees helped to carry out the affairs of the village administration. And with this, I am ending my history class. Now let me start your civics class. Political parties, objectives of the major All India parties, defects of the party system. The party system has many defects which may be stated as: number 1, party system has demoralized politics. The parties fill bitterness and prejudices into man's mind and even encourages partisan mentality. Irresponsible role of the party. Some objectionable methods are adopted by the parties. Either they bribe or threaten the voter. The whole purpose of the election is defeated if the parties hire musclemen to capture the polling booth. Corruption and misgovernment. Huge election funds are collected by the parties. The party in power distributes offices and official favors to its members regardless their competence. Unstable government. Multiplicity of parties in the country results in unstable government. The 12th Lok Sabha was dissolved after having been in existence for just 13 months. Conclusion. Thus, it is necessary that parties should be organized on the right lines and controlled by men of character. Party system. One party system, two party system and multi-party system. Party system should be described according to the number of parties a country has. One party system. In one party system, a single mass party is led by one man. Such a party system is mostly found in communist states. Such a system is opposed to the spirit of democracy. Civil liberties are severely restricted and the judiciary is not independent in these countries. The two-party system. In two-party system, the political loyalties of the voters are divided into two great political parties. Additional parties are either non-existent or powerless to accept public issues. Stable government is there. In the two-party system, unrealistic promises can never be made in the opposition parties. Multi-party system, more than two party represented in the legislature signifies a multi-party system. In case no party is able to form a ministry as Reserve condition of the government is for India has several national parties and a large number of members of the regional parties. Major of all India parties, a party recognition has an All India Party and its symbol for the election campaign. To be recognized as a national party, a party has to secure at least 6% of the valid votes polled in any four or more state in the last Lok Sabha or state assembly election and has to win at least 4 seats in the Lok Sabha for any state or states. A party can get a national status if at least 2% of the seats in the Lok Sabha in the last election, provided the members are drawn from at least 3 different states. And with this, I am ending my today's class. Goodbye.